नंबर 4 ऑफ चैप्टर 4 7 स्टैंडर्ड एनसीईआरटी सिलेबस. हियर वी आर स्टडीइंग चैप्टर नंबर 4. एज यू ऑल नो द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज हीट, राइट? इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट द ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट इन वेरियस सब्सटेंसेस. एज वी नो द डिफरेंट सब्सटेंसेस ट्रांसफर द हीट बाय डिफरेंट मेथड्स, से फॉर एग्जांपल कंडक्शन, convection. In the last lecture we studied about conduction, the heat transfer in the solid, right? The solid will transfer the heat from the hotter end of the object to the colder end by the process known as conduction. And in the liquids as well as in the gases, the heat is transferred through the process known as convection. Okay? Convection, in which heat will transfer from the hotter object to the colder object, or we can say in the liquid from the hotter molecules of the liquid to the colder molecules, right? So the amount which is there in any container gets heated, right? So we can say that these are the two main methods of heat transfer in the solids, that is conduction, and in liquids and gases, that is convection. Now in this lecture today we have to learn about the third process of heat transfer, which is known as radiation. So radiation is the process of heat transfer in which we do not require any medium. In conduction, we require solid for the transfer of heat. In convection, we require liquid or gases for transfer of heat. But in radiation, we do not require any medium for transfer of heat. Right? So, we can say that the process of heat transfer in which medium is not required. Without any medium, the heat can transfer. So, you may have a question, how is it possible? So, let me give you one simple example. The light of the sun or the heat rays from the sun is coming on the earth. Okay, we know that between the earth and the sun there is a gap, and this gap is known as space. In the space, as we all know, there is no air, there is no medium. Then also the heat rays of the sun is coming to the earth. How they come? So the answer of this question is they reach to the earth by the process of heat transfer known as radiation. As there is no medium in the space, the heat from the sun reaches to the earth by the process known as radiation. As I told you that the heat transfer by the radiation does not require any medium, right? So the heat from the sun reaches to the earth through radiation, right? So by this process we can get all the heat which reach to earth. Even when we sit in the room and we start the room heater, then we get heat from the same process, that is known as radiation. Through radiation, the heat is transferred in the room by the room heater, right? So this is the process by which the heat is transferred from the sun to the earth, and we can say it does not require any medium. Now our next topic is, what happens when heat falls on any object? We know that the heat from the sun falls on the earth. Then what happens? Okay, when heat falls on any object, there are three chances, right? Some of the heat, or we can say a part of the heat, will be absorbed by that object. A part of the heat will be reflected back in the atmosphere by that object. Then a part of the heat may be transferred, right? So this can be done. Now the question is, if a part of the heat is absorbed by the object, then what happens? Obviously, if the heat will be absorbed by any object, then that object becomes hot. You might have remembered that when you remove your shoes in the sunlight, okay, especially black colored shoes in the sunlight, then after some time it becomes hot. So when you try to wear, then you feel hot, right? Even the seat of our vehicles become hot, right, as they are black in color. So I can relate this example with this, that the some colors, say for example dark colors or black color, can absorb more heat compared to light colors, right? So our next topic is kinds of clothes we wear in summer and winter. We know that we wear different types of clothes in summer as well as in winter. Generally we wear cotton clothes or light colored clothes in summer, okay, and in winter generally we wear dark colored clothes and woolen clothes, right? So why we wear light colored clothes in summer and dark colored clothes in winter? The answer is that the dark color clothes or dark color can absorb more heat compared to light color. So if the clothes are of dark color, it can absorb more heat, and we require heat in winter. So in winter if we wear dark color clothes, then we feel warm. But if we wear the dark color clothes in the summer, then obviously we feel so much hot, right? And the other thing is that the light colored clothes or white clothes reflect more amount of heat compared to dark color clothes, right? So by wearing the light colored clothes or white colored clothes, we feel cool, right? That's why we wear this in summer. So we can say that the dark color surface absorb more amount of heat and the light colored surface reflect more amount of heat. Let's study this by doing an experiment. Take two identical tin cans. Paint the outer surface of one black and of other white. Pour equal amounts of water in each and leave them in the midday sun for about an hour with the thermometers. Measure the temperature of water in both the cans. Do you find any difference in the temperature? Yes, you are right. You can see that temperature is more in black colored can and temperature is less in white colored can. Right? Why this is so? As I told you that dark color surface absorb more amount of heat compared to light colored surface, right? So we can say that the can which is painted as black has more temperature compared to the can which is painted as white, right? Now fill the two cans which is used previously, that is the white colored and black color, with the same amount of hot water, okay? Then leave the cans in the room and or in a shade. Note the temperature of water after 10 to 15 minutes. Does the temperature of water in both the cans fall by the same amount? No. what happens actually, the temperature of the water which is there in the white colored can will fall more compared to the black colored can. Why is it so? Because as I told you, the white or light colored surface reflects more heat as compared to dark color. So we can say that we are wearing the light color clothes in summer and dark color clothes in the winter, because we feel comfortable with the dark color clothes in the winter as dark surfaces absorb more heat and light color clothes reflect most of the heat that falls on them, and therefore we feel more comfortable wearing light colored clothes in summer. By wearing dark colored clothes in winter, we feel warm. Even we know that the wool keeps us warm, right? We know that between the woolen fibers there are so many holes, and this hole trap the air. And as we know, air is poor conductor of heat, so it will not allow our body heat to pass into the surroundings, right? That's why we wear woolen clothes in the winter, which keep us warm, right? So this is all about the chapter heat. In the next lecture, we will going to discuss about the new chapter, that is of chemistry. The name of the chapter is acids, bases and salts. Till that, be at home, be safe. Thank you.